There's lightnings somewhere out there, and the J-20 pilots know it. Satellite surveillance tracked two of the American supercarriers, 700 miles east of Taiwan, out of range of all but the longest-range anti-ship ballistic missiles in the Chinese inventory. Normally, this would put Taiwan well out of the American Navy's F-35's combat range, but the U.S. Air Force's vast fleet of tanker aircraft has been flying non-stop circuits from Japan to top off inbound airwaves of Air Force and Navy fighter aircraft. Friendly AWACS easily picked out the big F-15s from hundreds of miles away, and the J-20s were burning fast to get into firing range. But the Chinese know American air doctrine well. Those F-15s aren't the tip of the spear, they're the shaft behind the tip. That invisible spear tip is somewhere out there, waiting to guide in long-range air-to-air missiles fired by the F-15s to their targets while remaining out of detection range. It's an unnerving thought, knowing that the threat is there but impossible to see. The comfort in each Chinese pilot's mind is that their J-20 is also stealthy, especially from the frontal aspect. It may not match American stealth technology, but it wasn't really designed to. The rest of the Chinese air fleet is over Taiwan or operating within a safety bubble provided by ground-based and ship-based air defenses. This flight of J-20s is out here well ahead of the rest of the fleet and on a very specific mission. The American AWACS is not hard to spot, nor are the accompanying tankers just a few dozen miles away. The J-20s burn fast now. Their new WS-15 engines allowing the J-20 to match the American F-22's ability to supercruise. However, Chinese engines are well behind American and European counterparts and have only been in full-rate production since 2023. On top of that, the J-20 experiences a malfunction as one of its engines flares out under the extreme stress placed upon it. The afflicted aircraft sputters and immediately loses airspeed. Its single working engine is powerful enough to get it home, but its pilot already knows the truth. There are lethal predators out there waiting to strike. Turning back would expose the plane's unstealthy rear to the enemy and ensure it becomes a fatality. Continuing forward will also ensure the American F-35s fire first. And with greatly reduced power output, the J-20 has no chance of notching the incoming missiles. The pilot pivots his aircraft up to gain some altitude, and then volley fires the four PL-15s loaded in its weapons bay. The Mad Dog maneuver is probably the best the pilot can do. The Americans are still outside of targeting range, but if there's any F-35s out there, the unguided missiles might just get close enough to pose a threat, or at least discourage them. Without guidance from the launching aircraft, the missiles instead activate their own guidance, going after the first target they inevitably illuminate, if anything at all. The stricken J-20 now banks to head for home, or at least attempt it. Based on estimates, the Americans should be able to detect them well enough to get weapons locked within a few dozen miles, as long as they're flying head-on at them. But the J-20's rear is far less stealthy, dramatically increasing that range, especially if any of the F-35s are flying with the new ISRT systems that the Americans have developed as upgrades to their F-22s. Only two dozen more miles to go before they're in range. An AIM-120 pounces down from above on the stricken J-20, breaking the aircraft in two. Somewhere 50 miles ahead of them, the firing F-35 easily picked up on the J-20's signature as the aircraft began wobbling, throwing transmitted radar energy back toward the American aircraft. The J-20 has several bumps and nodules along its body, which on their own already compromise its stealth. But in the wobble of an engine flare-out, the reflected radar energy is enough for the F-35's powerful onboard computer to get a firing solution. The American pilot had fired even before the J-20 had turned around in an attempt to flee. Its single engine still burning hot enough for his ISRT to easily track with a weapons-grade lock. Where there's one, there's more. And as the two flights merge toward each other at a combined speed of nearly 2,000 miles an hour, the J-20s now become targetable. The Americans begin ripple firing off AIM-120s, but the Chinese fire as well. Their PL-15s outrange the American AIM-120 by a significant margin, but they're not firing at the F-35s they can track yet, nor are they firing at the F-15 missile trucks approximately 100 miles behind them. Instead, the telephone pole-sized missiles are climbing into the upper atmosphere and tilting their noses forward, screaming along at the edge of space toward their real objectives, the American tankers and the AWACS aircraft. The J-20 versus the F-35. There's been much talk about these two aircraft, and we're here to settle the debate once and for all. Or at least as best as one could possibly settle this debate, given all the relevant information is classified and the two aircraft have never engaged in combat, let alone against each other. So until someone over at the War Thunder forums gets mad and publishes classified materials to win an internet argument, this is the best we'll be able to do for now. Both aircraft are entries into the fifth generation of fighter aircraft, another completely arbitrary distinction that really doesn't mean anything. However, what is undeniable is that both aircraft are a significant cut above what we would today consider a fourth generation and a deadly threat to anything that isn't a peer rival. Both aircraft are meant to become the backbone of their respective nations' fleets, with China currently fielding anywhere between 150 to 200 J-20s and building more, and the US having acquired about 450 of the F-35. It's unknown how many J-20s China plans on purchasing, but it's likely looking to completely replace its aging third generation and probably most of its fourth generation fleet with J-20s in the future. The US likewise is looking for the F-35 to become the primary fighter aircraft across the US Air Force, Navy, and Marine Corps, though it looks set to hang on to at least some upgraded F-15s in the future to serve as missile trucks that can fly alongside fifth or better generation aircraft and provide a volume of fire that traditional stealth aircraft lack due to their need to carry munitions internally. While both China and the US are actively working on more advanced aircraft even as they begin acquisitions of their fifth generation models, the US is significantly ahead of the curve with its next generation air dominance fighter, already having taken to the skies and expected to begin production by 2030. When it comes to its design, there's little doubt that China has made use of stolen American and Allied technology. There are striking similarities between the J-20 and America's fighters in the forward fuselage, air inlets, exhaust nozzle, and engine intakes. It's well known that China used various forms of espionage to acquire files on the F-35, although the US has stated that while these were controlled materials, they were not part of the highly classified technologies behind the F-35's stealth and other capabilities. Here, we have no choice but to take America's word for it, but it is doubtful that it would own up to having its most secret of secrets stolen. Yet there's also another reason for the similarities, chiefly that the shapes used by American stealth aircraft are simply optimal shapes for stealth overall, and if China did steal significantly sensitive secrets, they don't appear to have implemented many of them into the J-20's design. The aircraft features numerous features that comprise its stealthiness in comparison to American aircraft, including the use of canards and various small bumps and other areas that might protrude just a tiny bit from the body of the aircraft, but create enough of a radar return for extremely sensitive American radars to detect. The use of canards on the J-20 improved its ability to conduct supersonic and transonic turns, as well as aid in general maneuverability. However, their inclusion can be confusing, as they substantially reduce stealth performance, as do the small vertical winglets at the rear of the aircraft. They are clearly meant to aid in maneuvering, but given the close placement of its engines, thrust vectoring has reduced effectiveness. As a delta-wing aircraft, the J-20 is already at a disadvantage against highly agile fighters like the F-22 that it was meant to counter, and thus canards help in this regard. And yet, the J-20 is a pretty big aircraft, significantly larger than the F-35 or even F-22, and this, combined with a delta-wing configuration, puts it at a disadvantage in close-range fights. But this size hints that the J-20 is actually meant to act as a sniper, enjoying good frontal aspect stealth for long enough to fire its very long-range weapons at distant targets. You'd have to ask the Chinese why they decided to make what is essentially an interceptor into a half-baked dogfighter. It's possible that the J-20 was a compromise, with political pressure to create a fighter comparable to the F-22, but engineers faced with the reality of never matching US capabilities attempted to steer the aircraft's design toward a job it could do very well, take out support assets behind the line of contact. And therein is a major difference in the way these two aircraft are believed to be implemented in combat. The F-35 is both an air superiority and strike aircraft, but it can also operate as a mini AWACS and data node in a distributed network. New upgrades will further enhance the aircraft's ability to also conduct electronic warfare, enabling it to allegedly support itself in the electronic attack role, a claim that will only be verified in a shooting war. The F-35 is basically a quarterback in the sky, and while it doesn't excel at any one thing, it does a hell of a lot of them really well. In the future, NGAD fighters will be the tip of the spear, with F-35s right behind them, filling in for a whole range of capabilities. The J-20, on the other hand, seems to be tailored toward a specific mission set, itself influenced by the geography of any potential war between China and the US. In such a confrontation, likely over a Chinese invasion of Taiwan, China enjoys home field advantage, while the US has to fly its combat aircraft from over the horizon and out of range of Chinese missiles. This means that America will be wholly reliant on its fleet of AWACS and tankers, and destroying these critical links in the US combat network is likely the J-20's primary mission. America doesn't enjoy the luxury of having very specific combat scenarios to prepare for. The US is the current linchpin of global security, and it must be prepared to fight an array of conflicts. Thus, it's opted to produce an all-aspect stealth aircraft, or at least as close to it as possible. The J-20, though, takes a bit of a shortcut. With very good frontal aspect stealth while having significantly increased radar return from any other angle, estimated to be as much as 5 times greater than the F-35, but that frontal aspect stealth is likely enough to get the job done, penetrating deep enough into contested skies to target support aircraft well in the rear. Its twin engines are then well suited for powering the J-20 back to the safety of airspace controlled by dense air defenses. While the J-20 is picking off American tankers, AWACS, or even 4th-generation missile trucks like the F-15, the ability to do so greatly compromises an American response in the Pacific. Without AWACS, US stealth aircraft will have greatly reduced situational awareness, even if the F-35 does employ more advanced low probability of intercept and low probability of detection radars than the J-20. Without tankers, US aircraft will struggle to get into flight from usable airfields, which will be vulnerable to Chinese missile attacks anyway. The Navy's F-35Cs, the largest of the F-35 family, carry just shy of 20,000 pounds of fuel without drop tanks, while the J-20 carries over 26,000 pounds of fuel, giving the J-20 far more reach than the F-35 and the ability to push deep into the Pacific to fend off America's support aircraft. Worryingly, if America's 4th-gen fighters such as the F-15 and F-18 can't get into the fight, then the limited capacity of its F-35s and F-22s will significantly limit how effective these aircraft are in major air combat operations, which could require a minimum of 2 missiles per kill on a Chinese fighter. When it comes to weapons, both aircraft are limited if flying in their stealth configuration by the need to carry weapons internally. The J-20 ekes out an advantage over the F-35 due to its bigger size, carrying 4 mighty PL-15s with even greater range than the 4 American AIM-120s the F-35 packs, and the ability to include 2 additional shorter-range missiles in side base. Both nations, though, are implementing upgrades. The F-35 will soon carry 6 internal missiles, while the Chinese are aiming to also fit 6 PL-15s inside of existing J-20s. The F-35 will also start receiving the AIM-260, a significant upgrade over the AIM-120, which is already outclassed by its Chinese counterpart. A 2-stage missile, the AIM-260's ultimate range remains unknown, but it is stated to be significantly above that of even the PL-15. China, meanwhile, is developing its own answer to the AIM-260 already, though it seems unlikely it'll be fielded before America's new missile. The F-35 and the J-20 are also undergoing upgrades to enable unmanned teaming, or the ability to fly alongside drone wingmen. A key capability of the US Air Force's NGAD program, unmanned teaming will significantly increase the lethality and the capabilities of existing and future aircraft. These drone wingmen will be built to be disposable, cheap enough to be lost in number while still packing serious capabilities. Modern air-to-air combat, however, ultimately comes down to better pilots and better avionics, and here the US has a distinct advantage. Chinese pilots typically get around 110 flight hours per year versus 180 hours for American pilots. Both sides make extensive use of simulators, but stick time in an actual cockpit is an irreplaceable experience. So are combat missions, of which US pilots routinely engage while supporting partner and allied forces around the world. Chinese pilots, on the other hand, only ever truly have the chance to intimidate Taiwan's air defenses, a far cry from the veterancy that most US pilots enjoy. To add to the American edge is cooperation with global allies, especially in exercises such as the Red Flag that pits American airmen and their aircraft up against the best the US allies have. These force-on-force exercises don't just provide realistic experience, but invaluable insights on the strengths and weaknesses of America's aircraft and how to best maximize and mitigate both. American avionics are also estimated to be a generation and a half ahead of most Chinese counterparts, largely due to the US's long-held dominance in the tech sector. China has done impressive work catching up to U.S. electronics, but has been hampered by a lack of domestic experience and over-reliance on either reverse engineering or outright industrial theft. China has proven adept at stealing technology, but not so much at innovating it. As the U.S. moves on to new gallium nitride semiconductors for use in fighter radars, China is allegedly working on its own counterpart, but developing this and other advanced technologies has just become significantly harder for China thanks to President Joe Biden's ban on sales of advanced microchips to China. President Biden's ban has not just made it significantly harder and more expensive for China to get its hands on advanced microchips, but it also made it illegal for Americans to work with Chinese counterparts on the development of new semiconductors. The F-35 is overall the better aircraft, though the J-20 does enjoy a speed and payload advantage. Ultimately, though, the J-20 really doesn't have to be better than the F-35 if it can succeed at its primary mission, keeping all of the support aircraft the F-35 relies on out of the fight. Now go check out how U.S. military plans to shut down China in the Pacific, or click this other video instead.